can reach high magnitudes, resulting in severe duties of current interruption and recovery voltage to the grounding switches. For the aggravation of the phenomenon, I can point out two aspects very common in Brazilian electric network. Parallel circuits supported by double circuit towers with more proximity between the circuits, and long lines with shunt compensation with the possibility of resonance during unbalanced operation. The Brazilian experience dates from the middle 80s by switching off by grounding switches. Such high induced currents of 345 kV AC parallel circuits supported by double circuit towers at the receiving end of Itaipu AC transmission system. Calculated prospective duties were so severe and there were no standardized values at that time. The solution for fast arc extinction with flexible rods, you can see here, has shown to be the less expensive, the most reliable and easy to test at high voltage laboratories in Brazil. To implement and to substitute after some number of operations, and is largely applied in our days at voltage levels from 362 kV up to 800 kV. Tests performed at CEPEL Eletrobras Research Center in Rio de Janeiro for such 345 kV switches show two different situations: interruption without fast arc extinction and interruption with fast arc extinction. Let's see the small movies of each test. The first one, we can observe a low opening speed of the main grounding blade with long duration of the arc and consequent premature wear of contacts. In the second one, we still can see long speed of the long opening speed of main blade, but current is switched from main blade to flexible rod. In the sequence, we notice fast opening speed of flexible rod with the consequent fast arc extension. Regarding future needs, the increasing need to transmit large blocks of energy is a continuous challenge in Brazil. And one solution that has become a real alternative to better usage of right-of-ways, both in the construction of new lines as well as in the upgrading of the existing ones, is the so-called high-sill transmission line. The picture shows a prototype of an experimental solution installed in Rio de Janeiro, achieved with compact towers and asymmetrical expanded bundles for a 500 kV of twice the transmission capacity of a conventional 500 kV transmission line. I presented as a study committee B2 article at the 45th SIGRE session in 2014. Detailed information regarding this project. For such cases, the corresponding switch duties imposed to the ground switches could be even higher, so it can be used to justify the need for such an international survey. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, George. May I ask Mr. Matsumoto?